life and death. He trained to fight terrorists so we can have the kind of freedom that we experience right now and the fun that we're having right now sitting right here because of guys like Ron and Dan Jr. The only thing is, these guys fight in square rings. Ron McNair knew that he was going to be fighting in a square compound in Afghanistan. The fighters basically, they know. They're going to win, they're going to lose, they're going to hug each other, and they're going to go home to their families. Ron Jr. wondered, would he be coming back in one piece? Or would there be pieces missing? Would he be coming back in a body bag? And so Ron McNair headed off for about 8 months of hell in Afghanistan. Facing all the radicals and the extremists, again, who want to end our very existence. By the grace of God, Ron McNair Jr. returned home to us 1 year ago. Although honorably discharged, Corporal McNair remains a reservist. If he is needed, if the unthinkable should happen, Corporal McNair will be heading back into active duty. Until then, on a daily basis, he works with the Atlas Cops and Kids Foundation, almost on a daily basis working with them. He just believes in it so much. Also, he's going to be continuing his education, his future, and then he'll step into our future. We couldn't ask for anything more than a future that's led by Corporal Ron McNair Jr.
I salute him. I think we all should salute him.
God bless and happy holidays.
Ron McNair, don't go away.